Good morning, friends. I'm pleased to be able to welcome you all in yet another super session of Hands On, Plugs On, Minds On, an IIEPM original direct-to-home lecture series. I'm Professor Arpit Trivedi, your event host and moderator. Let me take you through the process, how we'll conduct the webinar today. Our guest will address the batch for 1 hour. First 50 minutes will be knowledge sharing session, and last 10 minutes will be questions and answers. Students are encouraged to put their relevant to the topic questions in the chat box. If you expect to earn more money in coming years, you have to listen and watch this session extremely carefully. You have to be extremely careful when you watch this session. The story is truly finished and meaning is made. Not when the author adds the last period, but when the reader enters. With today's agenda, reading habit for future managers, join me to welcome Mr. Jaideep Kotnis, a voracious reader, mentor to budding managers, a helping hand to colleagues, and lighthouse of direction to students. Jaideep sir completed Masters of Social Work in HRM from Maharaja Sayajirao University, Vadodara. Jaideep sir is alumnus of prestigious XLRI and has done certification in leadership and strategy from Jack Welch Management Institute affiliated to Myers University, Washington. Jaideep sir is a passionate HR leader who always found the right balance between people development and impacting business goals. Sir has close to 20 years of experience in various geographies across sectors such as pharma, turnkey projects, manufacturing, FMCG, and agri industries. Sir is currently head HR manufacturing operations for Goodyear South Asia Tires and member board of studies IIEBM. Sir has also worked in key leadership positions at JAPFA India, PepsiCo, Monsanto, Adani Group HR. Now I request Jaideep sir to address the batch.
Thank you very much for the nice introduction. Professor Arpit, I really loved the introduction and I would love to introduce you to my wife. I'm very happy. So good morning, everyone. Nice to meet all of you. I already see Anshul, Aprubha and Akanksha saying a good morning. Yeah. So today's the session that I'm going to share with you is about cultivating a reading habit that develops you into a business manager. So yes, before I start, please put your mobiles on silent mode, everyone. Yeah. So before I start with my session, I'd like to start by telling you a small story. Now, this is one of my favorite stories, you know, and this is a real life story that I'm sharing with you. Am I audible, I hope? Just write a yes in your chat, you know, so I come to know that I'm audible. Am I audible? Sunai de rahe sabko? Just write a yes in your chat so I understand.
Jaideep sir, you are very much audible, sir. Connectivity is good.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, Anshul, I'll take over that topic. I'm interested how to do. I know. I'll cover that in the question and answer session. So the story I want to tell you is a real life story. It is not a story I've read in a book or anything. You know, I was working for the Adani Group for around 4.5 years. During that time, I started my career in Adani Enterprises. Adani was a 15,600 crore company, and then we became a 19,800 crore company in 4 years. From 7 companies, we went to 13 companies. It was during that time that the Mundra port was already there, but Mundra SEZ aaya, Adani Power came up. We saw the actual, kya kehte hai, Bhumi Pujan of the power plant, and it was a big UMPP, that is 4,600 megawatt power plant. We also were deployed to a place called Gondia, which is in which is a district of Maharashtra with a border close to MP. There's a place called Thiroda where we were setting up a 1600 megawatt power plant. And in those days, way back in, if I remember, somewhere in 2006-07, the Naxalite problem was very much there. And we were actually deployed in Thiroda setting up the power plant. Now, the story is about a guy called Swapnil, which I wanted to share. In those days, I was a HR manager. I must be in my late 20s. I got along very well with the traders. Adani is a trading company. And there was a guy I remember called Swapnil. Swapnil was from IIM Ahmedabad. And he was a great trader. He used to do trading in coffee, you know, buying and selling of coffee beans. And Swapnil one fine day decided to resign. And he was a very important guy, and he was considered to be a top performer, a high performer. And Adani management ne bola, we need to retain this guy. In those days, 2007, the NCDX had just come in. Commodity trading was happening, and Adanis were the largest traders. Coffee cup business was something around 1800 crores. The entire agro desk division of Adani was at 4800 crores. So we are talking about big money. In those days, traders, you did not have MBA specializations like international business. Okay, you had MBA marketing, and each person, by virtue of his experience, by virtue of his taking interest, would get into the particular business. So Swapnil knew everything it was about coffee. Now he was a coffee trader. Coffee traders often, the business was very simple. We used to import coffee from Brazil, interestingly Vietnam, and we would then sell it to the major companies in India. That is, be it your Nescafes, your Nestles of the world, and the various other coffee and confectionery companies. We would even send it to companies like Cadbury's, which is now Mondelez. Now my job was tasked with retaining Swapnil. So Mr. Naresh Mehta, who was the then vice president, said ki jaldi hum log kabhi safed baal wale jo are young, you get along well with very people and with young people very well, and Swapnil is a good friend of yours, why don't you stick with him and try to convince him to stay back. Swapnil was from IIM Ahmedabad, he was from the full time band. So I sat with him one fine day, had a cup of coffee, and I said, kyun jana chahte, you're doing superbly well in Adani, pay is good, everything is nice, problem kya hai? You've even got 2 increments and the performance bonuses are also there. You're doing a fantastic job. And like all youngsters, Swapnil must have been, I was 28, 29 years old then. And Swapnil must have been 25 years old, 24, 25. He said, Jaideep, aisa hai ki yaar, don't take it personally. I love everything in Adani. I would not like to leave this group. It's a great group. But I want to experiment. I want to do something different in my life. You know, there are 3 friends of mine, and we are thinking of starting a boutique consultancy, and we are going to start something in Bombay. It was a time of startups. It was during that time Rashmi Bansal's book also came, that is Connecting the Dots, about MBA students not taking the road that is often treaded, having their own startups, having their own businesses. He says, I want to do something different. I don't want to work for one company. I want to look at the outlay of various companies, you know. So my understanding of the industry will be very high. So I gave Swapnil a very simple advice. I said, Swapnil, you keh raha hai to barabar hai, but tumhare 3 friends hai. What about finances and all? See, business karna is the good thing, but business karne ke liye you need a high level of risk appetite, risk lene ki shramata. 2, you need to have a lot of money. People with deep pockets can do that. You need a lot of finances. Doing trading of coffee and, you know, doing management is one part, but there you have a back office, you have support, you have people who are taking care of the funds, fund management is happening. So when you get into your own business of consultancy or setting up your own business, it's a different ball game. And then what about the culture, those 3 friends of yours with whom you're going to start the business? You will have difference of opinions and all, and you're very young. There are people who at a very young age of 24, 25 have started great businesses and they have done extremely well. But looking at your personality, knowing you since the past 2 years or so, I think it is not a very wise decision. But he said, nahi, mujhe jana hai. And then finally he left Adani somewhere in 2006. 7-8 months later, he gave me a call saying that I'm in Ahmedabad, can we meet up somewhere? Hamare office ke nazdik there was a crossword store. I used to love reading books. That's why I believe Arpit ji has given me this session. So I met Swapnil in crosswords. I had a discussion with him. I said, hi, hello, Swapnil. How are things going on? He said, I want to come back to Adani. I'm not doing very well in the consultants. I said, theek hai, Mehta ji se baat karta hun. During that time, Mr. Mehta was the VPHR. So I had a meeting arranged. Adani was also very happy to recruit him. It was a very happy ending. Swapnil joined the company again. But there was a small conversation of 10 minutes that I had with Swapnil. I asked him, why do you want to join back? It's only been 10 months. Then he told me that, see, I'm more of an executor. I like it when the results are taken. As a consultant, I consulted certain companies. These Indian companies are not very professional. They don't pay the money on time. We had fund issues. Secondly, even after doing a lot of research and advising, many of our clients or customers, they don't take our advices seriously. They take it very lightly. The level of empowerment is there, but the level of empowerment in execution is 0. These companies who we cater to only take advice from the business strategy consultants, but they don't implement many of our recommendations. And yes, the three friends that we started the consultancy, we all had our difference of opinions. Later, we had our own fights and we decided to separate. We terminated the consultancy. ये सब सुनने के बाद the first thing I told Swapnil, I could not help but say, I told you so. यार मैंने पहले कहा था तुम्हें ये होने को वाला है. मैं जानता हूँ. This is not the age. You still need to be a little more seasoned. Take some exposure of management and then start. So in all my naivety, in all my I told you so syndrome, I told Swapnil, I told you so. And I got a fantastic answer from Swapnil. He said, yes, Jaydeep, you did tell me, but I wanted to experience it myself. I wanted to do it. I wanted to take the experience myself. I wanted to see how it is. And this is the same thing with youngsters today. Not much has changed with the generations that have come. You know, you are the new millennial generation probably. Many of you would be born in the 90s or I don't know, 90s, I guess. Today, this is the same problem with parenting also. Today, a lot of professors, lecturers, parents, they give a lot of good advice. We prescribe a lot of things. Beta, achhi aadatein rehna rakhni chahiye. You should be very self-disciplined. You should read a lot of books. You should study. You should do something in life. Barabar. Everybody gives you advice. Everybody is like a doctor who is ready to give you some prescription. Ki aapko ye cheez karni chahiye, aisa behave karna chahiye, aisa aisa karna chahiye. And today's youngsters are very tired. They don't want this prescription. They want to experience life themselves. So if I am going to tell you today that reading books helps you, it's going to be prescriptive. It's going to be advice. Until and unless you yourself don't decide that I have to read or maybe I have to read something to make life better, till then you are never going to read. Trust me, my words are not going to make any impact on you. Until and unless you don't decide for it yourself. So that's the moral of the story of Swapnil that I was sharing with you. Until and unless you don't feel that you are going to implement it yourself, till then you will never feel. Just give me a minute. Yeah? Yeah. Hello. Okay. The second thing I wanted to share with you is the balloon story. I don't know how many of you have heard it. It's a very famous story. I read it in a book called You Can Win by Shiv Khera. The balloon story is a very famous story. Many motivational experts have shared this story in various forums, but this story always motivates me because ye story ka jo saar jo hai, moral jo hai, it really struck a chord with me in my heart. And that's why I always share this story in many of my sessions. The story is very simple. Ek bar there was a garden where a man was selling balloons. ढेर सारे बच्चे उससे बलून्स खरीद रहे थे. Those balloons had helium gas put in it and they were floating in the air. There were different kinds of balloon, red, blue, yellow, green. One of the small boys comes to the balloon guy and says, ये काला रंग का बलून आपने अभी तक इन्फ्लेट नहीं किया. Can it also fly into the air? Can it go into the air? That's what the little kids ask the balloon guy. And the balloon guy then explains to the kid, कि बेटा, it's not the color of the balloon or the size or shape of the balloon that makes it go into the air. It is what I fill into the balloon. It is what is inside the balloon that makes the balloon go, the gubbara go into the air, basically. And so true it is for all of us. It is not the color of our skin or the family that we belong to, the caste, community, region that we belong to that makes us successful. It is what is inside us, within us. It is our sincerity, our commitment to our career. It is our hard work that actually at the end of the day decides whether we are a success or failure. That is what I would like to share with you all. Now, coming to the habit of cultivating. A habit of reading books, I would say it is one of the best qualities that a person can possess. It helps a great deal in boosting your confidence, reduces your stress and puts you in a better mood. हर एक आदमी का एक फिक्स होता है. आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि रीडिंग ऑलवेज रिड्यूसेस. देयर आर सम पीपल फॉर हुम फिजिकल एक्टिविटी इज वेरी गुड. यू नो व्हेन आई वाज इन कॉलेज आई वाज नॉट मच ऑफ अ बुक रीडर. व्हेनेवर आई यूज्ड टू बी स्ट्रेस्ड और व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू बी वेरी वरीड, व्हाट आई यूज्ड टू डू इज आई यूज्ड टू प्ले फुटबॉल. देयर वाज अ नाइस फुटबॉल फील्ड और बारिश में मुझे फुटबॉल में वो ग्राउंड में रन करने में बहुत मजा आता. आई डोंट नो, आई यूज्ड टू एंजॉय प्लेइंग फुटबॉल. सॉकर वाज माय गेम. ऑफ कोर्स आई लाइक क्रिकेट आल्सो, बट बारिश में फील्ड में भागना और फिर वो फुटबॉल खेलना या क्रिकेट खेलना उसका एक अलग ही मजा आता है. At the end of the day, so I used to enjoy running around. As I matured, as I got more and more into management, I realized that any day a cup of coffee and a nice book is quite relaxing and soothing. So we all have our own fixes. For some of you, watching a Saas Bahu serial would also be a stress buster. We all have to find our own stress busters. But slowly what happens is you have to go to books. Two things I would like to tell you today. Never go for book summaries. They kill you. They don't give you the real learning or the message of the book. So avoid book summaries. That's point number one. Point number two, aajkal life mein har ek cheez ke liye Google hai. As Bill Gates very famously said, information at fingertips. For everything, it is my smartphone. It is like my TV. It is my dictionary. It is everything all put together. If there is anything, I just have to Google it out. So Googling is a very good thing. You must Google. But when it comes to reading a concept, a theory, a strategy, or a book, get the whole book and read the whole book. It does make a difference. क्योंकि जब आप Google करते हो या एक snippet पढ़ते हो या एक summary पढ़ते हो, the main element or the main learning of that theory somewhere is cut short. The person who has made the summary is aware, and on the basis of his understanding, he has put that summary. So you will miss out on some very good learnings if you don't read the whole book. Okay, reading is such a habit that once you start doing it, you will get addicted to it. As simple as that. Now, coming back to reading, why reading? What difference does it make? One, reading ke teen major advantages hai, the way I see it. The biggest advantage is it improves your knowledge. Aur aaj ki duniya mein information is power. If you are more informed, better informed than your competitor, you are likely to get ahead. Knowing is not enough. Knowing before your competitor is more important. Simple as that. So reading improves your information and knowledge. Second advantage of reading is it improves your language, your vocabulary. I don't know how many of you speak very good English. I remember when I was in Jaffa, I was ADP, I was heading the India HR operations. Our corporate headquarters was in Singapore. The India regional corporate office was in Pune. And three times in a year, I had to travel to Singapore for our business review meetings, every time. Our group HR head was a Singaporean guy called Jasper Tan. He was a Singaporean who had been educated in Cambridge in UK, and then he had done something from Tangerang Institute of Management in Singapore, which is like their IIM. It is one of the best management institute. It's also Tangerang Institute of Management is also called Southeast Asia Institute of Management. And Jasper Tan had also worked for 10 years in the Singaporean Army in their military intelligence wing. Then he did his management and became a group HR. And he was fond of using a lot of American phrases and a lot of muhavras in English. Now, if you're not well-read, you don't read books, you will never understand what the other person is saying. In one of the meetings, we were discussing about the implementation of SAP HR, or SAP HR mein kaise mapping hoga, kya hoga. Being the India HR head, I was sitting with the other HR heads who were my counterparts and peer group. I remember Bui Quinh was the Vietnam head. Madam Nguyen was the Myanmar's HR head. Then we had Anna Chan, who was handling the cluster of Philippines, Hong Kong. And then there was a Chinese gentleman who was looking at our China business. The China headquarters were in those days called Shanghai. So all the, there were some four, and of course we had the Indonesians also. The Jakarta HR head was also sitting next to us. His name was Porbito. Now, while we were discussing about SAP HR and mapping, suddenly we got the news that SAP HR has been delayed by another 2 years because of budgetary constraint. But in the initial phase one, Indonesia will be covered and the other countries will not be covered. Now, my Vietnamese HR head was a very passionate guy, and he wanted SAP, and he wanted to make a point that, sir, manufacturing business jo hamara hai, Jaffa ka, and the consumer business are two different business. One was a ready-to-eat food, jaise ki aapke ready-to-eat noodles, cutlets, chicken cutlets or your veg cutlets, aloo tikki, you just fry it and eat it. So that was one business, and the other was the manufacturing business. He was trying to make a point that the manufacturing and the consumer business have to be separated in the SAP HR. As it is, they are going to make two different companies now. They are going to split the company so that they can go public. He was trying to make that point. So Jasper Tan suddenly shut him up and said, don't flog the dead horse. Don't flog the dead horse is what Jasper said. Now I understood what Jasper meant. But the Vietnamese guy got confused. Iska agar aap English translation karoge Hindi mein, to mare hue ghode ko chabuk mat maarna. So Jasper said, don't flog the dead horse. Ye ek English muhavra hai. What this actually means is, jo cheez discuss karne jaisi nahi, jo cheez khatam ho chuki hai, usko discuss mat karo. Main irritate hoga. Humne already bol diya ki SAP 2 saal se delay ho chuka hai, to SAP ke bare mein discussion karne ki zarurat nahi. Time hamara zaya jayega. That is what he was trying to say. Now the Vietnamese guy looks at me and says, horse? Where did the horse come from? The Chinese guy who was sitting next to me says, horse, very tasty. I thought we were having chicken for lunch. We are going to have horse meat. मुझे पता नहीं चला कि मैं हंसूं या मुंह बंद रखूं. I was feeling the whole matter to be very hilarious. Now this happens when you don't read books. This happens when your command on the language is not there. So this is a muhavara. Again, while we were sitting in Pune corporate office and some discussion was going on, हमारे managing director of India ने पूछे CFO को मजाक में कुछ तो बोला. He was a very intelligent guy, my CFO, earlier CFO. Of course, now we are media side. He was a Marwadi gentleman, and we were just having a general discussion with him. And while talking, the MD just jokingly said something to him, and the CFO got very serious. He was a chartered accountant, I said. And the MD said, "Arey, I am pulling your leg. No need to get serious." So the poor chap looked under the table, pulling my leg. So again, this is another muhavra in English. Pulling your leg matlab mazak karna. Arey, main aapke saath, I'm just joking with you. Don't take it serious. And there was again embarrassed silence. MD started looking at me. नीचे क्यों देख रहा है? I said, because you said pulling the leg. He is checking. इसका पंख खींच रहे हैं. So we all had a good laugh. I realized that English is a language which has its own peculiarities. Unless and until you don't read, you will never get a command over the various phrases that are being used, the various sayings that are being used. So, and that's why reading becomes very important, because when you are interacting with expatriates or foreigners or people who are well read into this language, you will seem like a person who is not very well educated, or a person who lacks certain. I know English is not everything, but then that is the international language. And the more you read, the more command you have over the communication. There are many words in English as well as French which have double meanings. One word can have two different meanings, positive as well as negative. ठीक है, जिनको हम कभी कभी पन भी कहते हैं या ऑक्सीमोरॉन भी कहते हैं. अ सिंपल सेंटेंस लाइक द एम्बेसडर लाइज अब्रॉड फॉर द सेक ऑफ हिज कंट्री. सो दिस सिंपल सेंटेंस मींस ही लाइज अब्रॉड मींस ही स्टेज अब्रॉड. और दूसरा लाइ का मतलब है झूठ बोलना. सो ही लाइज अब्रॉड फॉर द सेक ऑफ हिज कंट्री. सो वन वर्ड हैविंग मल्टीपल मीनिंग. सो योर कमांड ओवर लैंग्वेज गोज ऑन. एंड द लास्ट थिंग दैट इज अ एडवांटेज ऑफ रीडिंग दैट आई वुड से इज योर प्रोस्पेक्टिव, योर थिंकिंग होराइजन वाइडेंस. See, you may all have certain aspirations, ambitions. I want to do this, I want to do that. The more you read, the more you understand the thought processes of other management experts, you will slowly realize that yes, maybe jo main soch raha tha mujhe ye nahi karna hai, mujhe ye karna hai. Many of you would say that okay, I'm an engineer, I want to get into marketing, I want to get into sales, and that too I want to get into a sales of a particular sector. Maybe after reading books you realize that after doing engineering, hey, maybe I find some other aspect of marketing more interesting, maybe like branding or product positioning. The more you read, you realize, oh, Coca-Cola or PepsiCo ke wars the, you had the cola wars. Or you read about a sector like the airline sector. The airline sector is currently very much into the news. What is the future of the airline sector, keeping in mind the COVID crisis? A lot of things are going on. Or the hospitality industry. Many of you who have relatives in the hospitality industry, when I say hospitality industry, I talk about the big four or five players in the country. You know, you have the Oberoi's, the Taj group of hotels, you have the Marriott's. So how is the hospitality industry going to shape in the next 12 months with COVID? So the more you read, the more your knowledge goes up. You understand the nuances of the industry, you understand the working of the industry. So reading books is not only reading some very heavy management wala book. It also means reading general magazines, reading newspapers. I have seen a lot of CFOs and top management people at least spend half an hour of their day reading the newspaper, be it the hard copy or be it online. They just go through the news. What are the sectoral changes? What is government doing? How is it going to impact us at the end of the day? Now somebody had asked a very nice question about, sir, what do you do when there is a topic which is very boring or you don't feel like yeah, I am going to suggest you a lot of books. Don't worry. Sir, कुछ चीजें हमें पसंद नहीं आती फिर भी पढ़नी होती है तो कैसा करें? भाई अभी तक तुम्हारी शादी नहीं हुई है. जब शादी होगी तब तुम समझ जाओगे. मुझे जो वेजिटेबल सब्जी पसंद भी नहीं आती है ना, वो मेरे प्लेट में अगर परोसी जाती है तो मुझे वो खानी ही पड़ती है, अगर मुझे अगला मील चाहिए तो. सो सिमिलरली एट टाइम्स देयर आर, कभी कभी मम्मी भी हमारे घर में करेले का एक सब्जी बना ही देती है. You may like it, you may not like it. If it is nutritious, if it is good for us, you may have to eat it. There are various ways for you. If there is a very dry subject and you're not interested in reading, but it's a part of your syllabus or it's a good thing and you have to read it, then what I would suggest is there are three ways of doing it. One way is you break it up into points. वो एक underline करने की आदत होती है. अगर आपको वो दिमाग में नहीं जा रहा, आपको बहुत boring लगता है, तो just break it up into points and just write down whatever it is that you're reading. Because when you, I hope I have enough time. Another 15 minutes I have.
Yes, sir. If you suggest, I have already taken the questions from students.
Okay.
Shall I start putting questions to you, sir?
Yes, you can. You can.
So the first question that has come from a student of Jammu.
Okay.
Sir, how should I develop the ability to read for long hours and still remember what I have read?
Okay. You will have to take out the time for reading for long hours. I would say don't read for long hours. That is not a good thing. It is not the quantum of time that is required for reading, but what you read in that and what you understand in that particular limited time is what matters. I have personally experienced it in my board exams, 10th and 12th or post graduation exams, ki kabhi kabhi main wo pamphlet leke book leke baithta tha for 4 hours 3 hours, but wo bahut dheere dheere dimag mein mere jata tha. Aur exams ke pehle ek raat pehle, just before the exam, main book leke padhta tha aur sab kuch mujhe samajh mein aata tha within 5 minutes, within 2 minutes, because the pressure was there at the end of the day. So read what you like is what I would say. If you want to develop a habit of cultivating the reading habit, then read what you like. Start with comics, as simple as Amar Chitra Katha comics or Champak or whatever. Start reading first something that you like, and then slowly get into those management books. Automatically, शरीर को आपकी आँखों को वो आदत हो जाएगी.
This question is from a student of mine from Durgapur. Sir, how will we rate reading newspaper, magazine, and book to develop reading habit?
You have to take the newspaper every day and you have to read it. Now, if you feel it's boring or what you should do is you should have a friend group. See, how I developed the habit of cultivating the newspaper reading from my daughter is I would say that you read the newspaper. मैं तुम्हें बेटा questions पूछने वाला हूँ उस newspaper से. आपने क्या पढ़ा? So if the finance minister has said something or if home minister is saying something about some state, I will ask her, or I will ask her a simple question like, who is the finance minister of India? Do you know? Then she'll say, oh, it's Nirmala Sitharaman. Who is the minister of state for finance? If you have read, it's going to be her. So she knows ki na papa is going to ask me all questions about newspaper. So she ensures that newspaper is there. And again, most of you are graduates, right? आप लोगों ने ग्रेजुएशन तो किया ही है, इंजीनियरिंग, बीकॉम, बीए, व्हाटएवर. द बेस्ट वे टू कल्टीवेट दिस हैबिट ऑफ रीडिंग इज हैविंग अ स्टडी सर्कल और हैविंग अ बुक लवर्स फोरम ऑफ फ्रेंड्स. यार तूने आज क्या पढ़ा, तूने क्या पढ़ा, रीड अ बुक एंड डिस्कस अबाउट इट, डिस्कस इट विद पीपल, व्हाट इज इट दैट यू हैव रीड, द अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड रिटेनेबिलिटी विल बी हायर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
सर, दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ माइन फ्रॉम इंदौर.
Okay.
I can read in vernacular language for hours, but when it comes to English, I find it so difficult. Please suggest.
Sir, I am learning Marathi today. I am a Maharashtrian, but Maharashtra mein pichle 12 saal se, even today when I have to read Marathi, mujhe dheere 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 padhna hota hai. My subordinates look at me and say, goodness, sir, because I was born and brought up in Baroda, Gujarat. I am the fourth generation which is born in Gujarat. I learned my mother tongue at the age of 10 years. I speak Gujarati very fluently. I can read, write, speak Gujarati absolutely fast. Even the alphabets like J, K are different. L is the Devanagari script, but these alphabets are also very different. You will have to practice. Practice makes a man perfect. And as I said, if you find English reading to be tough, then welcome to the technology age. You have e-books, जहाँ पे आप audio भी सुन सकते हो. You get those audio books also. And you even have a reader nowadays. Google में तो वो Google आपको पढ़ के बता सकता है. Even on the computer, you have a reading software.
True. Sir, next question is a former student of mine from Chandigarh. Sir, if I decide to develop reading habit from today, what books would you recommend?
Whatever you are interested in. What is it that you are interested in? You want me to recommend a book of strategy, something on management, something on something that will help you in your life, a generic book? What is it that you want to read?
suggest at least 2 to 3 books in management.
There are suggest which will really help you. The first book is 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. Read about those 7 habits. 2 is Antara. I will get back to your chat. I am reading something. Anyway, Arpit ji will ask the question. Sir. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. The second is read a book called Built to Last. Built to Last is a fantastic book written by a guy called Collins, Jim Collins, I believe. He speaks about companies that have survived for 100 years. 100 saal hue, but ye companies ban nahi hue. They kept ticking, they kept doing very well. What was the secret? People then went to Collins and said, we want another book. And then he has put another book, Built to Last Part 2 bhi aa chuka hai. Also read the book In Search of Excellence. That's another good book. I believe it was written by Tom Peters. And then Return to Excellence. I remember in one of these books, there was a beautiful story about the Thimble Company of London. It used to make those beautiful needles and the needle needle threader. You know, purane zamane mein crochet, embroidery or seena logon ko bahut pasand tha. So this company used to make those silver tipped, aluminium tipped, beautiful needles. Now what happened was, over a period of time, sewing machines came from Japan and people lost that art of doing embroidery, or the art of stitching something went out. And then today we have tailors to do that job. So it went out. But that company used to manufacture very high precision needles. So they had to reinvent themselves. So what they did is they got into surgical equipments. They realized that doctors, surgeons also do operations and they also have to stitch the human body. So they made, and they also got into research and they made that thread which is a soluble thread, you know, the thread dissolves once the stitching happens. So these companies reinvented themselves. They understood. Again, you have the Toyota manufacturing company. Toyota was a manufacturing company that used to make textile machines. Over a period of time, textile slump came and Toyota was making a lot of equipment and machinery that could be used in cars. So one fine day, the older son said, let's make cars, and that's how the Toyota manufacturing company happened. The rest is history. Yeah. Next question, please.
Sir, this is again a question.
What I'll do is, I'll also send you a list of books which you can circulate to other books. Sometime.
Yes, sir. That will be great, sir. That will be wonderful, sir. Okay. Sir, this question is from a student from Balasore in Odisha. Sir, I have read somewhere that training your eyes is one of the most essential aspects to develop good reading habit. Please suggest, how can I train my eyes?
How can you train your eye? Okay, I would suggest, rather than training your eye, there are various kinds of reading habits, you know, crisscross reading, fast reading, skipping a word reading. There's a book which talks about this. It's called Basic Managerial Skills for All, written by an author called Father McGrath. Father McGrath was a Jesuit priest who started XLRI Jamshedpur. XLRI mein wo teacher bhi the. He was a Jesuit priest. He was a very knowledgeable person, in which there is a chapter that talks about reading. So there are various kinds of reading. One of the biggest mistakes of reading is we do the typewriter reading. Typewriter mein wo aise jaake fir wo ting hota tha. We again go back to the sentence. So if you want to do fast reading, the words in between, or you do it cross. Basically, if you want to develop fast reading habits rather than developing your, what you need to do is, you need to do 4 major things. One, set a time for reading. Set a time when you are alone. 2, take a book that you enjoy or are interested in. Automatically, reading will become a joy for you. It will not become a work for you. The moment it becomes a work for you, you will have to take efforts. 2, reduce your cell phone usage. Wo game band kar do. Wo jishka wale game aata hai na, in the Call of Duty. Aajkal ke youngsters ko bahut maza aata hai logon ko maarna. My daughter always plays that. Yeah, or a game hota hai, Temple Run. You keep running and then you, and there is a Subway Surfer game where you keep jumping over trains. Stop playing those games. Get out of Netflix, Amazon Prime. Minimize your mobile phone usage. Automatically, aap books padhoge. And the last is, discuss what you read with your friends. Talk or with family members. Start talking. This is what I read. What do you think? Automatically, that interest will go. And lastly, I would just like to say, make notes of what you read. It will help. Yeah.
Sir, this is a very different question, but I would like to take this question. A student has just written in simple words to me. Again, this student is from Dehradun, Sir, paperback or PDFs? Sorry?
Paperbacks or PDFs?
Yeah.
It depends. Some like tea, some like coffee. Some people are comfortable reading something on the screen, computer screen. I like to hold the book in my hands. I like to smell that paperback. I like paperback. I'm old fashioned guy. Now I'm in the industry. I like holding a paper in my hand and, you know, reading it rather than looking at it on the tablet or the mobile. Both things are doable. Whatever you are comfortable in. But itna hai ki paperback mein bahut bada advantage hota hai. You can underline, you can write a scribble a note or something in pencil. You can even do it on a tab. You can even do it on a tab. It's up to you. But agar aap PDF mein book padh rahe ho, don't go for a book summary. The whole book has to be there on PDF. That's all.
Sir, next question is from your hometown. And it is from Surendranagar, a student from Surendranagar of mine. He has asked, sir, audiobooks and podcasts are killing the flair for reading.
Okay.
What are your views?
I think any knowledge source is a good source. Today, with COVID-19 scenario, with social distancing, yes, it is a very effective tool.
Sir, the next question is, fiction or non-fiction, which helps improve reading quality?
As I said, it depends on your interest. If you ask me, I actually itna avid reader nahi tha. My first book my dad gave me, my dad used to be in the, jab hum log bachpan mein the to vacations mein we used to go to our relatives' place. Abhi aajkal itna nahi hota, but purane zamane mein hum log sab apne relatives ke place jaate, then we would all travel by trains. We did not have planes then. और बहुत मजा आता था. कजिन्स कभी कभी हमारे घर आते थे समर वेकेशन में, हम उनके घर जाते थे. और रेलवे स्टेशन में वी यूज्ड टू, माय फादर यूज्ड टू ऑलवेज बाय अस अ चंपक, अ चंदा मामा और अ टिंकल, आई रिमेंबर. एंड वी यूज्ड टू ऑलवेज गेट अ मिरिंडा और अ लिम्का गोल्ड स्पॉट. वो जमाने में वी यूज्ड टू एंजॉय रीडिंग दोस बुक्स. बाय रीडिंग दोस बुक्स आई स्लोली गॉट इनटू रीडिंग मोर एंड मोर कॉमिक्स लाइक एस्टेरिक्स, ओबेलिक्स, टिंटिन, फैंटम, टार्ज़न एटसेट्रा. देन आई स्लोली ग्रेजुएटेड इनटू नॉवेल्स लाइक जेफरी आर्चर, सिडनी शेल्डन, एलिस्टर मैकलीन. आई एंजॉयड दोस क्राइम नॉवेल्स or those thrillers. Crime novels, mein Agatha Christie is one of my favorite authors when it comes to murder mystery. Even today, there are a lot of movies made, a lot of episodes made on Agatha Christie's murders, but I still enjoy reading the book because the author writes with that beautiful clarity and, you know, the suspense slowly, slowly unfolds with each chapter. Jeffrey Archer is a great guy. Frederick Forsyth is a British author who writes very well. So I started reading novels. That got me interested into reading. And then slowly, the next step was gradually into management books. So that's my story. I don't know your story. See, I may like coffee, you may like tea, and somebody may not like coffee or tea. Somebody may like just a glass of brew. Simple as that. Somebody may like lemonade. So you have to find your own fix. And as I said, with the story of Swapnil, main bhaiya aapko nahi batane wala ki ye karna hai, wo karna hai. You have to experience it yourself. That's the biggest mistake today parents, teachers, and guides do. They give a solution कि भैया ऐसा करोगे, ये गोली खाओगे तो आप ठीक हो जाओगे. ऐसा नहीं है. We all have to find our own fix. I think Brilliant Mistakes is a brilliant book. Yeah, next question please.
Sir, this is from a student of mine from Delhi.
Yeah.
Sir, I have 60 days before I join IIEBM and I come to the campus. What should be my strategy to improve English and improve my reading skills?
Any language you want to learn, you have to start talking it. By reading a book on English, improving English language, you will never learn English. Speak the language as much as possible. Have study groups. Interact with like-minded people who are serious. Agar aap UPSC ke successful students ko dekhoge, those who have cracked the IAS, IPS exam, by reading, they have never cracked it. It's always through study groups. You start talking to people. It becomes an interactive process. Have like-minded people. Talk to them. Find mentors. Find coaches who are senior in the industry. Talk to them. Have a half an hour discussion of nothing but general knowledge sharing. Sir, aap kaise ho? Ji, main theek hu. Aap kaise ho? Ji, main bhi theek hu. And then you start on a topic. I do that with some of my DRs of my earlier companies, even today. We all have a time on Saturday or Sunday and then we just share what we have read in the week. That's what keeps them motivated in reading or studying. In fact, I'm reading a very interesting book called Let Me Say It Now, by a guy called Rakesh Maria. Rakesh Maria was the former commissioner of police of Bombay. He's an IPS officer. And he was there during the bomb blast of 91 and the train blast happened when Kasab came, and even he was the investigation officer of that Indrani.
Indrani.
TV Wali.
Yeah, about it.
So he was the chief investigation team officer, and now he has put everything, his memories and dealing with politician and situation. It's a very interesting book. Yeah.
Sir, the next question is from a student of mine from Patna. So reading in the morning or reading at night, which will improve my reading skills?
Again, I am not going to prescribe. I am not a doctor. Ki ye dawai lo beta, tum theek ho jaye. Aisa nahi hai. Find out the time where you are the most efficient. Frankly speaking, my sister used to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning and she would study and she would do a great job. मैं कभी 9 बजे से पहले उठता नहीं था. I need 9 to 10 hours of sleep. मेरे पिताजी मुझे हिला के धमका डरा के स्कूल में भेजते थे, which was at 7 o'clock in the morning, और ठंड में उस कंबल के बाहर निकलने में मुझे बड़ी दिक्कत होती थी. और जैसे वैसे करके भाग दौड़ के 6 बजे उठ के मैं स्कूल पहुंचता था. You ask me to stay awake in the night, I can stay awake till 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock. I'm an owl. मैं थोड़ा उल्लू टाइप आदमी हूँ. मैं पूरी रात जाग सकता हूँ, पढ़ाई कर सकता हूँ. मैं 2 बजे रात को सो के अर्ली मॉर्निंग उठ के मुझे सब कुछ याद रहेगा. सो एवरी पर्सन हैज देयर ओन टाइम. सम पीपल आर वेरी इफेक्टिव इन द नाइट, सम पीपल आर एक्सट्रीमली इफेक्टिव इन द मॉर्निंग, एंड सम पीपल आर वेरी इफेक्टिव इन द इवनिंग. नाउ देयर इज अ गाय कॉल्ड रॉबिन शर्मा हु हैज रिटन अ फैंटास्टिक बुक कॉल्ड 5 AM क्लब. आई डोंट अग्री विद. हर एक आदमी 5 बजे नहीं उठ सकता. इट डिपेंड्स, बट यस, यू हैव टू बी डिसिप्लिन्ड. आपको वो 2 घंटे जो देने हैं किताब के लिए या जो अपने पर्सनल टाइम के लिए, पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट के लिए, वो देने हैं. बीट इन द आफ्टरनून, इवनिंग, मॉर्निंग, इट्स अप टू यू. कुछ लोगों को घर के भी काम होते हैं. देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ फीमेल स्टूडेंट्स आउट देयर हु हैव फैमिली रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, उनको खाने में भी हाथ बटाना पड़ता है. आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि बॉयज डोंट हेल्प, बट लड़कियों से एक्सपेक्टेशन ज्यादा होता है कि भैया रसोई में और घर में थोड़ा हाथ में, यू नो, हाथ ज्यादा बटाना. सो फॉर देम आई वुड से find your own right time when you are most effective. Next question.
Sir, this is a question asked from many students of mine, that when you pick up a book, you are committed to the book, then how you fulfill the commitment of finishing it? The bigger problem is you have done so much searching on the book, you have picked up the book, but you don't want to finish, or you don't have ability to finish. So how to that, how the commitment should get done?
It's all about self-discipline. It's all about self-discipline. That's it. मुझे अपना वजन कम करना है. It is very difficult for me to stop eating. मुझे खाना कम करना पड़ेगा, but मैं छोड़ ही नहीं सकता. मुझे गुलाब जामुन, रसगुल्ले रोज खाने, मुझे रोज कुछ स्वीट खाने, और चिप्स देख के तो मुझे बहुत मजा आता है. और आजकल तो वो कोविड क्राइसिस में मैगी नूडल्स के बिना तो मैं जिंदा ही नहीं रह सकता. बट इफ आई कीप ऑन ईटिंग दैट फूड, हाउ विल आई बी एबल टू लिव? देयर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल स्टोरी इन गुजरात. देयर वाज दिस गाय कॉल्ड प्रमुख स्वामी. ही वाज द हेड ऑफ अ कल्ट कॉल्ड स्वामी नारायण. देयर इन गुजरात देयर इज अ वेरी बिग स्वामी नारायण टेम्पल एंड देयर इज अ स्वामी नारायण रिलीजियस कल्ट. सो प्रमुख स्वामी के पास एक बार एक आदमी आता है, बोलता है कि मुझे शराब छोड़नी है. मैं शराब नहीं छोड़ पा रहा हूँ. मैंने बहुत ट्राई किया, डी एडिक्शन सेंटर में गया, मैंने सब कुछ किया, बट मुझसे हो नहीं रहा है. प्लीज हेल्प मी. सो दिस गाय प्रमुख स्वामी, हु इज द हेड ऑफ स्वामी नारायण, वेरी नॉलेजेबल गाय, वेरी इंटेलिजेंट गाय, ही हैड गॉन टू हिज आश्रम. ही सेज कि गिव मी सम टाइम, तुम मुझे कल सुबह मिलना, मैं बताऊंगा. सडनली इन द नाइट एट 12:13 द नाइट, 12:30 AM, स्वामी नारायण कि वो आश्रम में जोर जोर से प्रमुख स्वामी का आवाज आता है, हेल्प मी, हेल्प मी, हेल्प मी, बचाओ बचाओ बचाओ. सब लोग दौड़ भाग के आते हैं. इवन दैट पर्सन कम्स, प्रमुख स्वामी हैज गॉट होल्ड ऑफ अ बिग पिलर. यू नो वो आश्रम में ढेर सारे ऐसे बड़े बड़े बीम्स और पिलर्स होते हैं. इट्स लाइक अ ओपन कोर्टयार्ड. ही हैज गॉट होल्ड ऑफ अ पिलर एंड ही सेइंग, हेल्प मी, दिस पिलर इज नॉट लेटिंग मी गो. मैं इस पिलर से चिपक गया हूं, मैं कैसे अपने आप को छुड़ा सकता. दैट गाय कम्स एंड सेज, क्या बात कर रहे हो प्रमुख स्वामी, आपको छोड़ना है उस पिलर को, पिलर ने आपको थोड़ी पकड़ के रखा. He says, नहीं, मैं बहुत ट्राई कर रहा हूं, पर मैं छोड़ नहीं पा रहा. सो एवरीबडी इज ट्राइंग टू हेल्प दिस पुअर प्रमुख स्वामी, स्वामी बाय पुलिंग हिज हैंड्स एंड ऑल. बट द मोर पीपल कैच होल्ड ऑफ प्रमुख स्वामी, द मोर टाइटली ही कैचेस द पिलर. फाइनली दैट गाय सेज, ये नौटंकी चल रही है, नौटंकी बंद करो स्वामी जी, आपने उस पिलर को पकड़ चुका है. जब आप इस पिलर को छोड़ोगे, इस खंबे को छोड़ोगे, ऑटोमेटिकली आपका प्रॉब्लम खत्म होगा. सो प्रमुख स्वामी लीव्स द पिलर एंड सेज, मैं भी वही बोल रहा हूँ, मैं भी वही तुम्हें कहना चाहता था. Jab, when you decide in your mind you have to leave that alcohol habit, is the time you will be able to get out of this habit. Simple as that. I feel reading books is good. It's not a waste of time. I was just going through a chat of Jyoti Nautiyal. She says, is it a waste of time to read, not to read? Well, I would say that, what is it that you are reading? मतलब कोई मुझे पूछ रहा है, सब खाना चाहिए कि नहीं खाना चाहिए? बिल्कुल खाना चाहिए, जिंदा रहने के लिए. सब पकौड़ी खाओ, पानी पूरी खाओ, कि रगड़ा पैटिस खाओ, कि भेलपूरी खाओ. अरे भैया, बाहर का खाना नहीं खाना चाहिए अभी. घर में बनाओ भेलपूरी, पानी पूरी, पकौड़ी. पानी पूरी का मसाला भी मिलता है, पानी पूरी के पूरी भी मिलते हैं. घर के पानी में बना के खाओ, मसाला डाल के. सर मैं पानी पूरी खाऊं कि भेल खाऊं, कौन सा खाऊं सर? या मैं रोटी सब्जी खाऊं? इट्स अप टू यू. यू डिसाइड आपको क्या खाना है. I am not going to prescribe you or advise you कि तुम्हें ये पढ़ना है या वो पढ़ना है. Find out what is it that you are interested in. If you are new to reading and if you want to ask me what books should I avoid reading, I would say don't avoid anything. I would say start picking. See, वो बोलते हैं ना कि when the student is ready, बुद्धा ने कहा है, when the student is ready, the teacher appears. वैसे ये हर book पे लिखा होता है पढ़ने वाले का नाम. मैं तो यही बोलता हूँ. आप बुक हाथ में लो, कोई भी बुक, कोई बुक स्टोर में जाके पढ़ो. यू फाइंड इट इंटरेस्टिंग, रीड इट. इफ यू डोंट फाइंड इट इंटरेस्टिंग, जस्ट कीप इट, टेक अनदर बुक. सम पीपल दे टेक अ बुक ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद एंड से बहुत हैवी है यार, क्या मतलब कितना बोल रहा है. एंड सम पीपल दे लुक एट द स्वामी विवेकानंद बुक. पीपल हु आर लाइक 18 19 इयर्स ओल्ड स्टिल इन देयर ग्रेजुएशन, तक पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन तक भी पहुंचे नहीं, फर्स्ट ईयर और सेकंड ईयर ऑफ कॉलेज, एंड दे से यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट ही सेड. आई कैन रिलेट टू इट. Very powerful statement of Swami Vivekananda. You know, I was sad for not having good shoes in my feet until I saw the man on the street, jiske paas feet nahi the, who did not have legs. So somebody, one of the youngsters said while interacting in one of the colleges, graduation college, sir, I can relate to this. I said, why can you relate to this? Tum itna relate kaise karte ho? Bola sir, accident mein mere pitaji ke dono paav chale gaye. He's on a wheelchair. I understand. Har ek ke next question.
Sir, this question is on piracy.
Piracy?
Yeah. Okay. Piracy in India. Books available on the street. Is it right to buy from there?
Ma'am, sankat mein darte hain mujhe aapne. Morally, no. But main khud buy karta hun. The way I say it, gyan, yes, I agree there is something called patency and copyright. But gyan, gyan hota hai. Main to ye manta hun. So I do buy second hand books on Ferguson College Road and in camp. If I'm getting a 150 rupee book in, let's say, 120 bucks or 150 bucks, I know it's pirated in a way. The texture is not good, but it's the knowledge that matters. There's another good book that I liked. I don't know whether you will like it or not. It's called Swimming with the Sharks Without Being Eaten by Harvey Mackay. How to survive in corporate kind of a scenario. If you are interested in history, then there's a beautiful book called From Battlefields to Boardroom by Dennis something, I forget. I'll send you the list. Battlefield, so how emperors and kings, Alexander and the Greeks, they won battles. Or business strategy ne 200 saal baad wahi strategy use karke business mein takeovers or hostile acquisitions, mergers and acquisitions ki. How war strategy were used in business strategy. That's another very good book. There are three books that you should actually read about. Three people you should Google about. One is Claude von Clausewitz. Just write down this name. C-L-A-U-D-E. I'll just type it so you come to know. C-L-A-U-D-E. C-L-A-U-Z-W-I-T-Z. Clausewitz. Please read this. Also read another book called The Art of War by Sun Tzu.
Sun Tzu.
He write T-Z-U-N. When I went to China and Singapore, I realized it's not Sun Tzu. In Chinese, it is pronounced as Sun Tzu. Actual name is Sun Tzu and not Sun Tzu. We do the anglicized British pronunciation. Next question, sir.
Sir, this question is on, sir, why Indian authors are not that celebrated in the world compared to British or Americans? Although I also tend to disagree, but sir, your views.
I think, yes, you're right. Indian authors have always been the underdogs. They've always been underestimated. But then you have some great Indian authors like Prakash. Prakash, he has written the book, Prakash Reddy, I forget his last name. He's written a book called The Secrets of Leadership. Then you have a lot of Indian authors as well. The Buck Stops Here by Gurmeet Singh. That's another good book. Then you have Arindam Chaudhary, who has written some books, The Great Indian Dream. Jugaad, another book, Jaydeep Bhatnagar and Arindam Chaudhary has written. Jugaad, how Indians have always managed with things. You ask a German worker to work, he'll say, give me a plan, give me a masterpiece. You ask a British worker to work, he'll say, I need the tools. You ask an American worker to give you results, he'll say, I want benefit salary. But if you ask an Indian worker to work without the right tools, without the right methodology, he'll still do some jugaad and he'll get it done. Indians are known for generating the maximum kaizens outside of Japan. और अगर डेमिंग अवार्ड देखोगे तो इट्स मोर ऑफ आदित्य बिरला ग्रुप. आज के पिछले 6 साल में देखोगे द नंबर ऑफ इंडियन कंपनीज हैज स्वेल्ड लाइक एनीथिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ कैसन प्रोसेस इंप्रूवमेंट्स. यस, इंडियन ऑथर्स आर नॉट वेरी वेल एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज ऑफ नाउ, आई एग्री. और कुछ अच्छे इंडियन ऑथर्स को भी एक फॉरेन ऑथर का नाम डालना पड़ता है, को राइट करना पड़ता है, सो दैट दैट बुक गेट्स एक्सेप्टेंस. इट्स अ कल्चरल थिंग, आई वुड से अ रेसिस्ट थिंग इन अ वे. या
Sir, this question is, should I read Ramayana, Mahabharata or Bhagavad Gita or interpretation by Devdutt Pattanaik?
Well, there is a guy called Mr. Pattanaik who has done a great job. He has taken stories of Ramayana, Mahabharata and then converted into management theories. Ramayana and Mahabharata have been like not only the holy books of the Indians, but they have also inspired people to make movies. Now, just yesterday I was sitting in the house and dekhte Amazon Prime pe, I wonder was it Netflix, I don't remember, ek purana picture maine dekha. The name of the movie is Rajneeti. Katrina Kaif. It's a beautiful movie, but if you look at the storyline of that movie, it's nothing but Mahabharata replayed out again with modern characters. There are a lot of management lessons from the Mahabharata and Ramayana which are now coming up. You can read whatever you like. I'm not going to tell you read Ramayana or Mahabharata. Read whatever you like. As long as there should be some fayda out of it. Khane mein kaisa hota hai? Nutrition milna chahiye. Phir aap bhel puri khao, gol gappe khao ya roti sabzi khao. Uska kuch nutritional value hona chahiye. That's all.
Sir, this is a very beautiful question from a student of mine from Junjunu. He asks, if you are stuck in an island with a book, which book will that be? Why?
Very difficult, very, very difficult question. There is no one book I can say I like. There are plenty of books that I like. If I was stuck in an island and I had to choose the one book, then it would depend on my mood. मेरे मूड के हिसाब से लेता मैं चूज करता. आई कैनॉट बी पार्शियल टू एनी वन बुक. एवरी बुक हैज इट्स ओन कहानी, इट्स ओन स्टोरी.
सर,
इट कैनॉट बी वन बुक, इट हैज टू बी मेनी बुक्स.
सर, अंडरस्टैंडिंग योर एंगेजमेंट बाय नेक्स्ट फ्यू मिनट्स, सर दिस इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन दैट आई विल टेक. एंड सर, द क्वेश्चन गोज लाइक दिस, दैट व्हिच बुक has inspired you the most in your professional career?
If you ask me which book has actually inspired me the most, then it would be Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, which I just now mentioned by Stephen Covey. It is not the Seven Habits, but the Seven Habits cover a lot of things. Covey has got hit the nail on the head. He has got some things very right. He talks about a vicious circle, a virtuous circle. It's a very great book. There's another great book which I would like to recommend to everybody. Name of the book is How Long Till I Get My Soul Right. It's a beautiful book. It's written by an Israeli. I'll mail you the list of the books, Arpitji.
Yes.
These two books have really influenced me. Seven Habits has influenced me the most. If you ask me the Seven Habits, I can tell you the Seven Habits right now. Mujhe zubaan nahi aata. And every time I take some 3-4 seconds or 5 seconds to remember a habit, that means I am not implementing it. Somewhere it is at the back of my mind, but I'm not executing it. I would like to say a few things if there are no more questions quickly.
Sir, please.
Say that if you guys want to be successful in life, there are no shortcuts. By reading a book, you are not going to be, you're not going to have guaranteed success. Definitely it will help in your success. I'll tell you the stories of three people. You know, at the age of 18 years, there was this guy who lost his father. His father died. Next morning, he went to play for his team. He had to play a very critical match. And his mother and all family members said, beta chhod de, kya zarurat hai, your father has expired. But he said no. But he said no, I have to play this match. And he went ahead and he played. There's another second story. They say every 9 out of 10 startups fail every single year. They He was this guy who started something on his own. बाद में तो इतनी बुरी हालत हुई that he had to live in a hostel, he had to skip meals, he had to walk long distances, चलते चलते ताकि वो टैक्सी और बस का फेयर बचा सके. Things were in a very bad shape for him. He had to attend work meetings walking and then he had to survive जैसे वैसे. And then one fine day what happens is Modi ji demonetization and everything करते 2014 or 15 I believe and suddenly his company grows by 400%. Actually, his company becomes a $7 billion company and his personal net worth goes to 1.3 billion. Can you imagine? So this is a story. A girl from Meerut in India had a scoliosis. She had a problem of the spinal cord. She could not do anything. It's a spine disorder. She was physically differently abled. She tried for the UPSC. She got into the Indian Revenue Services. They didn't allow her to in her office in the IRS. She was not allowed to take charge of the office because of her handicap. She again gave her the UPSC exam. She gave it 4 times. And then in the year 2015, she scored the first rank in her IAS. Period. Today she is a collector. There are many stories. What I would say is while we are all waiting for the perfect opportunity to come along, we fail to see that it is right in front of us. It is right there. It is all within us. The balloon story, always remember, it is inside you. There was a guy, there was an actor who was rejected in all the movies that he went. He struggled for almost 3 to 4 years. Finally, after 4 years of struggle, he got the first movie and that to a role of 1 minute 33 seconds. Can you believe? 1 minute 33 seconds ka hi pehla role tha. In the second movie, his role was of 2 minutes 25 seconds. Third movie, 2 minutes 5 seconds. Logon ko laga ab to ye khatam ho chuka. Still he kept trying. He got the National Award for Acting and he played the most controversial character in history, being a Muslim actor, the Hindu Hriday Samrat. He played the role of Balasaheb Thackeray. Do you know who I'm talking about? Nawazuddin Siddiqui. So all these people had only one thing in common, the way I see it. And that was they didn't give up. They kept on going. They kept on doing something. They believed in themselves. They had a conviction to do something. So the same is with reading books. You have to find your own concoction. You have to find your own magic. And you have to keep at it. Can I play a small video for 2 minutes?
Sir, please.
Thank you. So all these stories are replicated in that video. Is the video visible?
So we'll start from the media center.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Beautiful video.
Thank you, sir. And those, I see some chat comments. I was just going through some of the chat comments. Some of the people are finding it difficult to read. Maybe you can take some questions from them, which I can answer from my email ID.
Yes, sir. We will send those questions to you soon, sir.
Yeah.
On behalf of IIEBM Indus Business School, I thank Jaideep sir for such an informative and interesting session, helping students recognize the value of reading as a habit and clearing their real doubts. Sir, we'll be interacting with you in times to come. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.
Thank you.